minutes.
Oh, your 10 minutes starts now.
So maybe you wonder why I gather all of you today in this beautiful garden. But allow me to tell you a story of long time ago. So in the beginning there was God, and everything was made by plants and animals in the lands and in the sky. And the last he made was human. At first human walked with 4 feet, but their limbs are weak, and the nature itself was full of danger, and it's impossible to stay alive. But God took pity on them, gave them special bones. Bones strong enough for their 2 feet, and bones nimble enough for their hands. Hands that uses any kind of tools, and hands that will bring them to rule over the nature. And 1,000 years after, humans built anything, achieved many things, did great things, but at last, they built a thing, an ungrateful thing, a thing that defied the nature's will, a thing which will become their doom. So, you guess what they built? Actually, they built this one. This is one of the smart chair. It was called the eye chair. So, this smart chair provides you with anything, foods, drinks, and you didn't even have to move. You just push one button, and it will do anything that you need. And this made the human become very, very lazy. And thus the God was very angry with human, and he put a curse on them. So the human bone becomes very, very fragile, and even by just walking, moving, it will be very, very painful for them. Yes, it is truly a curse for you. And the name for this disease is the bone curse. Sorry. So meanwhile, in a far, far away country, lived a doctor. His name was John Hope. It's only coincidental. he was a smart and kind doctor. And he lives very happily with his wife and his only daughter. But one day a change happened. It's like the bone curse reached their village, and it's like his wife and his daughter was struck by the bone curse. And then John Hope, he decided to find a cure for this bone curse. So he studied the bones. Actually, and when he studied the bone, he learns a very, very extraordinary things about bones. So it's strong, but it's very light. You may think that it was made from perfect material like diamonds, or a strong material like steel. But actually it was not. It was made from 2 imperfect material. We see here that it was made from a weak yet flexible fiber called the collagen. And it was made from a strong yet brittle stone called hydrox. These 2 material was beautifully combined by a bone fairy called the obi cells. Yes. These obi cells, besides combining these 2 material, is also maintaining the growth. And it's continually renew your bones for as long as that human lives. And here's the problem. The curse meant the bone fairy was sick. And you can imagine, right, what happened if the bone fairy was sick. It's like the bone becomes very fragile and it's become very brittle. And then the John Hope, he thought that the solution of this curse is just to heal the bone fairy. And at the same time, if you want to relieve the patient from his pain, you want to support their bone with some kind of scaffolding material. And here's one problem again. If you want to heal the bone fairy, the drug should be added in a very, very high concentration. So the drug must not stick with the scaffold material. But limited by the time, he was reluctantly applying this premature idea to his wife. And unfortunately, his wife was dead. And after a few days of mourning, he finally succeeded to gather his courage. And he bring his wife's body, and he and he buries his wife in this very same garden. Saddened by his father, his daughter painfully stand up, and she takes away one of the roses and gives it to her father. But unfortunately, the father was still grieving. He did not well want to receive this rose. And he said to his daughter, "If you want to amaze me, don't give, show me magic, not this kind of things." But rejection from his father does not make his daughter giving up. She wanders away and she stumbles upon an unexpected image. And she gives it to his father. So, to her father. So basically what she gives to his father was a magnet. And he showed it to his father and he said, Daddy, don't you think this is amazing? Like, because anything is could adhere to the magnet. But the father was like, no, it's just a magnet. But then father got some inspiration. He talks like, wait a minute, magnet? Attractions? And then he got an idea. What if I make the drug become a magnetic? And I make the scaffold become magnetic? It should be like an attraction, right? Yes. And in this way, he tried to add cola fiber and the hypops. And he adds the magnetic powder. Can he get the magnetic scaffold? Oh, yes, it works. The second one, you want to link the drug and the magnetic powder. And will it become magnetic also? Yes, you're right. It also become magnetic. And then he desired to make this into the reality. And he developed his findings. Unfortunately, he didn't brave enough to just apply this idea because he didn't want to have anyone suffer the same fate as his wife. But it's like his daughter know what was in his heart. And then she came to him and she said, "Sorry, I forgot." And she said, "It's okay, Nini. I believe in you. Whatever you do, you will always be in my heart." And then the journal successfully gathered his courage, and he put his finding in his daughter. He put it in his daughter and he gives her every day a drug. One day, 2 days, 3 days, third day, 4 days, 5 days. And finally his daughter was getting better and she was relieved from the waters. And soon the Jorhok goes to the capital. He reports his finding. And soon the people of the world was relieved from this burning curse. But yet he refused to receive any fame, any wealth from his finding. And rather he goes back to his village and he lives peacefully with his daughter. And people now may forget his name, they didn't know the Jorhok, but his story will always be remembered as the tale of Bowen Moses in the village.